stance in the back. I mean, he is absolutely braced. You need to loosen up a little bit, partner. Back up a second. There you go. Okay, well, I don't want to back you into that flag. I know it's back there, and so do you. I know it's back there, and so do you. Yeah. Kisses. There you go. Give him kisses, huh? All right, let's work on this side. Here we go. I'm going to push this hip away. Excellent. Look at that. He's almost as light as Jewel. And I think it's not so much that he has learned. He's just spooky. Huh. Can you cross over in the front? That's a boy. All right. All right, I'm going to try something new. I'm going to try to move your hips from right here. Okay, this is where the stirrup would hang. This is where I would hit you with my heel, bumping you with my heel, asking you to move your hips over. And he's walking forward. He doesn't know what to do. There it is. There's that sideways step. You see all the tail swishing going on there? Yeah. It's ticklish. He wasn't sure what that was all about and what he was supposed to do. But boy, he's doing a lot of licking and chewing. Yeah. Doing a lot of licking and chewing. Okay, we're going to try this again, honey. Ready? Right here. Now, when you first start this, this is not necessarily a good place to be with a worried horse. I'm pushing and pushing and pushing. He's not doing anything. He wants to look at it. He's going to swish at me with his tail. As long as he doesn't kick at it, I'm all right. Come on, sweetie. And I've got myself in a position now. This is my weak right shoulder, too. Come on. Okay, I'm going to try to help him here so I don't get kicked. I'm trying to help him find the way. That's it. See, I tilted his head. When I say I'm helping him, I tilted his head in the direction to bend him, to make him break his hips loose and move him. But see, what I've done there is introduced a second cue. The second cue is pulling his head around. So, which is what I want him to do, you know, when he turns, you know, we pull his head around and break those hips loose, and boom, there they go. But I need him to respond to that one cue. Come on back over here so you're in the camera, honey. Good boy, right there. Oh. What I need him to do is to respond solely to this cue, so that when I finally get up in the saddle and my feet hang right there, and I give him a little poke with my heel, he'll break those hips loose and move those hips over. Him starting it again. There, look at that, beautiful. That's, now he didn't learn that. I mean, it doesn't mean he knows it. A lot of things were going on there. He's moving up front, he moved back a step, moved up front, and then he swung his hips. That's all part of the trial and error that the horse uses to learn. It's operant conditioning. They just keep trying things and trying things and trying things until the pressure goes away. And the last thing that they did that made the pressure go away is what they remember. And if you do it consistently over and over and over again, the same release at the same time after the same response, then it becomes automatic. But it takes weeks, if not months, of conditioning for the horse to finally not have to think about what you're asking or try to figure out what you're asking, is to just do it. I mean, it's like swatting at flies. They don't even think about it. That's the way you can get them to move, and that's how you get them to be so light, is constant conditioning to that. Now, I don't want to wear him out on it. I'm going to try him on the other side. And usually I have a hoof pick or a crop handle or something like that to push with so that the... There, okay. I was very light. He moved back and then he moved away, but he moved in the direction I wanted him to go, so that's fine. I mean, I'm not going to expect perfect responses from him at this stage. I'm not going to expect perfect responses from him for a long time. But as long as he's getting the general idea and he's trying, I mean, you got to reward the slightest try. You know, at this stage, he just doesn't know. So as you keep rewarding, you know, a little try. I mean, even if he only just shifted his weight, I would have rewarded that too. Now I'm going to try something different with him. In fact, I need to get rid of this flag. I don't want him getting worried on me in the middle of the pen. Not happy with a whole lot of things, huh? It was hard just getting him to accept me wearing this ball cap. Oh, easy, honey. You see how easily he flinches? I mean, I didn't move up on him all that fast. It's just that his mind was somewhere else, and all of a sudden my hand was there, and his immediate response was, I need to get out of here. Somebody's abused his head. There's no doubt in my mind about it. Somebody's abused his head, and that's hard to get that confidence back. Okay, come on over here, Ho. Good boy. Now, I'm going to try something that I have never tried with him before. I don't want to get kicked. I don't want to get kicked. I'm going to try to get that tail, or get enough of it. Easy now. That scared him. Yes, I know. That's his instinctive response. Because out in the wild, and we know Big Al has lived out in the wild, huh? You have lived out in the wild and had to dodge all those mountain lions and wolves and coyotes and everything that come after you, huh? Can I have that tail? Can I have it? No, he's got it clamped down. Boy, he's got that clamped down tight. That's a worried horse when they got a clamped down tail. Yeah, it is. It's okay. I don't want to get kicked. No, I don't. It's okay. Now, what I'm trying to do here is get him to move forward in a calm fashion, and that's not working because he's so flighty. He's afraid. He's got to run. Even though I can control his head, he swings those hips out. It's okay. It's okay, honey. And he's got to protect himself. He's afraid because that's where the wolves grab onto. Yeah. But the idea is to get him moving in a circle, and I'm trying to do this without lunging him, or without chasing him with the flag. Yeah, I know, honey. This is a lot easier to do with Missy, but he needs it done too. It's okay, honey. It's okay. I don't need to get myself kicked here. It's all right. There we go. See? It's okay. Yeah. Try to get him to let me handle this tail. Yeah, I know. It's okay. Okay, yeah. Down here in the vulnerable areas again. Make sure he'll let me in there. Yeah. I'm gonna try that tail. There we go. I need to be able to handle this so I can brush it eventually, honey. Yeah. Well, you got a knot in there. Boy, just as soon as I put a teeny bit, just a couple ounces of pressure on that lead rope, he's letting that tail cut loose. Yeah, he's swinging those hips around. It's all right. Here we go. He's starting to cock his leg a little bit. Let's try this side over here. Yeah. Yeah, sweetie. There you go. Okay, maybe we'll pull it on this side too. Hey, look at that. No problem. You're not used to having that tail handle at all, are you? No, you're not. Well, that's okay. Doesn't even want me back there now, do you? You don't even want me back there now. Yeah, see the swishing going on? Boy, he's upset. He's upset with that. He's upset with everything. You get upset with everything. Yeah, you do. You get upset with everything. Everything's a bother to you, isn't it? Yeah, getting a little better about the years, though, here, huh? Just a little. I don't know whether it tickles or... I don't think it tickles him that much. I think he's... The only way they could handle him was to ear twitch him. I mean, that's the easiest thing to grab onto when you're got a horse that's hard to catch out in the pasture and hard to handle because nobody took any time with him. So they grabbed under those ears and cranked the hell out of them. Thank goodness they didn't bend any cartilage. Yeah, okay. We'll just tickle that. We'll just rub that here. Yeah, okay. There we go. This is an endorphin release point right behind the ears. And again, I know there's no camera resolution, but once I get up here and get my thumb and my middle finger in those little pockets behind the ears and start to rub, you can feel him relax and he starts licking and chewing. Yeah, it takes about 30 seconds of good consistent pressure to get the endorphins circulating until they get to the brain. It has a calming effect. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. That's a good boy. Yeah. Boy, for me to be able to get in here and give him kisses and put my head right up against his, this is probably the biggest strides that I've made with him since I've had him. To be that trustful of me. Especially with me wearing a ball cap. My God. And, you know, he'll be different tomorrow. I'll walk out in the backyard wearing a ball cap and he'll see it and he'll panic and run. But just about everybody that worked with him up there at the training center or worked with him, chased him, handled him, they all wore ball caps. And boy, when I come out here with my wide brim hat, never seen one. Doesn't know who I am. Yeah, even the sunglasses. Even the sunglasses, huh? Yeah, let me flip this rope up here. Let me flip it up. It's not hurting. Nobody's going to whip you. Yeah. And flip it over your head. Oh, it's all right. It's all right. See, look at the flinch here. Yeah, look at the flinch. It's okay if I move it slow. Well, I woke up one of the birds. It's all right, honey. It's all right. Good boy. Good boy. I'm bringing it up over your head here. Oh, it fell off. It fell off. Yeah, it did. There you go. See? It's just a rope. I don't like Missy's cough. I don't like her cough. Yeah, there we go.